What's up, good people? Mark Holmes here. As always, I appreciate each and every one of you guys, as well as you ladies. We are 4 hours away from kickoff, and I am making some ultimate playoff chili here. Yeah, this is like ultimate meats. I mean, if you're a meat lover, you're going to love this, because look, we got ourselves some stew meat here that we've seasoned up with chipotle chili powder. We've got garlic salt. We got cumin in there. We got pepper. We've got smoked paprika. And we are browning this right now. And you can see it's a flour on top of it too. So that way it'll lock in the juices and stuff in here. And here I got some bacon. Now we're not going to do the bacon so it's crispy. We're going to keep this bacon nice and soft in here. And then we're going to go ahead and saute our onions, and we have red pepper that's in there. This is my favorite sausage. Oh my goodness. This is homestyle food sausage, okay? I got mild and I got spicy. And what I've done is I've actually cut this in 4 pieces, and we're going to chop that up because we're going to add that into it. Incredible taste, incredible flavor. You will just love this. And of course, I got my mama's tomatoes and Rotel. That'll go in here. This will be spicy. It will be meaty. Oh, there's ground beef too. It'll be spicy. It'll be meaty. And of course, we're going to end up taking our ancho peppers. My ancho peppers here, check this out. These are like dried peppers. And what we've done is we're soaking them in water. And after they get soft, we're going to take and pull out the seeds and the stems. And we're going to put that with some olive oil along with the jalapeno pepper and some other chilies in there, and we're gonna make a chili paste. And this is gonna make this like red. I mean red. It's gonna be a red, spicy chili that'll be ready for playoffs. Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs. Playoffs. So we're gonna get our bacon out of here, and we're gonna use that bacon grease in there for the onions to give it some extra flavor. Now, what happens with this chili is it's got layers of flavor into it because you got the bacon, and if you can keep that away from my wife, and you've got, of course, the meat here, which is already seasoned, that's going to give you a different flavor, and then you got the ground beef in there, and then you got that chili paste. Oh my goodness. This is like the perfect storm of flavor. I'm gonna take care of my hands, okay? I'm gonna wash my hands real good, okay? So we got that. Now 2 pounds of ground beef. Now what we're gonna do, because we're playing the Packers, is we're gonna have plenty of cheese to go on this. So we're gonna cook the onions and the hamburger in here, and then we'll drain the grease off of this, and then we'll be able to add the tomatoes and things and the beef, and we're gonna let that slow cook for about 4 hours. And that's gonna soften up the beef in here. Look at that beef. Look at that, oh my goodness. You see that? It's like got its own gravy up in there. And what we're gonna do after we cook this is we're gonna take some of the tomato juice, and we're going to put it in here, and we're going to pull off all of that wonderful flavor that's in there. Look at that. That just looks, I know what you want to do. You want to go ahead right now, and you want to get some bread and just put some of that beef right there on there. Oh my good, look at that. Oh, it's saucy. Okay. See now, this chili right here, is kind of like a beef stew. And it's gonna be so good. Oh my goodness. Look at it. Make sure you scrape that on off of there. See, that's the flour that's in there. It's helping to marry up on that stuff. And we'll get the hamburger ground up, browned, drain this, and then we'll be able to start putting in the next layers of ingredients. Once we get this done, we'll end up taking the meat off of here, and we'll put that tomatoes, oops, in there to get that flavor. Look at that. Mm. Got my spicy sausage cut. All right, that's perfect. We'll put this aside until we have the other meat ready to go. We'll pull off all that flavor. You want that sauce. You need that sauce. I'm gonna taste a piece of it. Mmm. That's good. Mmm. Get all of that off of there. Mm. Makes it easier cleaning the pan too. Ooh yeah. Now we don't want to put that in here until after we drain the meat. But now, this is almost like our roux. This has the flour that's in it. It has the spices that are in there. And that beef, this is like beef bouillon. Look at that. Look at that. Woo! That right there is the best flavoring you will ever get. We're just gonna put all this back on top of the meat. And then we're gonna let that get hot again, and we're gonna put all this sausage in there. Okay. Yeah, that's getting hot. It's getting hot in here. All right, and the meat here is all looks brown. Now remember, never ever put the grease down your trap. All right, so we're coming down. You see we got our ground beef right now. It is all brown. The onions are caramelized and everything else in there. We put some chipotle chili powder, a little bit of salt in there. And I've got a jar of my mama's tomatoes. Now, when she cans these tomatoes, there's no preservatives in there other than a little bit of salt. And the tomatoes are nice and soft, which is great, because what happens is they just basically dissolve in here. And you can see how nice that looks. I'm gonna put 2 quarts of those in there. I'm gonna put a couple of cans of Rotel, which will give us a little bit more spice. And their tomatoes are actually a little firmer. Now what you want though, is you wanna have plenty of liquid in here, because this is basically gonna be like a stew. Now we've got our bacon. Bacon can go in there. There we go. Shout out to the bacon. And we're still, the peppers, when they're soft, they look like this. Some of these are still drying out here, so I'm going to have to wait about another half hour or so. And you can see all the sausage in here. We're not going to put the grease in from the sausage. And that's why we actually took that separate from this. We don't want it to be greasy. Now this chili gets better with time. You want to cook this nice and slow, because that'll allow the meat to get nice and soft. You want it to be where it just literally melts in your mouth with all that flavor. So you see my mama's tomatoes, you see the Rotel, you see that liquid that's in there. And what's going to happen when we add all this beef with that reduction in there, that is just going to explode inside of this. Look at this. Oh, man. Oh, look at that. Look at that flavor just dripping. The flavor's dripping in there. And you can see how it's already getting the color in there. You've got all this wonderful meat. This is like the ultimate stew of chilies. And then we're gonna add that sausage to it. You will have so many different tastes when you get a spoonful of this. It will blow your mind. Because you got the mild sausage, you get the kick from the hot sausage. You've got the seasoned beef, you got the ground beef, you got the bacon. Oh, Nelly. Try to leave the grease behind. And remember, don't put that down your sink. Okay? Let's take a look here. Look at that. You see all that meat? This is the ultimate meat chili. And you can see how it's already a little bit thick. Now we may need to add a little bit more tomato of my mom's liquid wise on here if it reduces down. But we want this now, put a top on it and turn it down low and just let it simmer. And this thing, when that beef gets tender and those flavors, and once I put the red chili pepper in here, oh, it's gonna be so good. And I'll be back when I do the chili paste. All right, so we're gonna check in on our ultimate playoff chili. Okay, so what we've done is we've gotten it so it's hot. We've turned it down on low because we want to cook it low and slow. You look at that color in there. I forgot to mention that there's also, I put about 6 or 7 cloves of garlic in here. We've got cumin in here. We've got our regular chili powder in here, as well as I love chipotle chili powder in here. Now this one I didn't make real spicy hot, because I'm gonna end up having some for my in-laws and for my parents, and I don't want to heat them up too much, but we got all kinds of hot sauces with it. And you can see, you see all those meats in there? You can see the bacon, you can see the sausage, you can see the ground beef, you can see the chuck roast that is chopped up. And we're just gonna let this cook for about the next 3 hours, really low and slow. And what'll happen is the beef will get really, really just fall apart. It will literally just melt in your mouth. Now the last thing I still need to do, I ended up putting them in a jar because my peppers weren't getting soft enough. They were basically floating. They're almost soft enough now that I can turn them into the paste. I'll put a couple cloves of garlic in there, a little bit of olive oil, and we'll put them in the ninja. Ninja them up, and we'll make our chili paste, and we'll use that to taste. And this, my friend, it's going to be ready. I don't know if the Cowboys will be, but this is going to be ready. Okay, so my peppers have finally gotten soft. So here's what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the stems out and take the seeds out, and we're going to put that in our ninja. And what this is going to do is, and this is what I do. Now again, there's more than one way to skin a cat. I put a couple of cloves of garlic in there, and I put some garlic salt in there as well. We're going to grind this up, and I add a little bit of olive oil. Basically, the olive oil will help to lubricate it up a little bit in the blender. And this amazing thing is, this looks kind of like it's a dark brown, but once it's blended up, it gets like a really bright red color to it. And this has tons and tons of flavor in it. Yeah, that's all of it. Okay, put a little olive oil in with it. Oops. We're gonna blend this real quick, and this will make our chili paste. I thought I had more of them than this, but see, you have more of them in there helps to blend it a little bit better. Add a little bit more olive oil into it. That'll help. It's just not enough in there. Usually I do a whole bag. There's our chili paste. I need to blend it just a little bit more. It needs a little more substance in there to really get into it. Right now it's kind of like it's ground, but not as fine as I'd like. And I think it's mainly because I don't have enough in there to grind it up. If I go get like a jalapeno pepper or something else just to give it a little bit more weight, that'll help. So we're gonna go do that. All right, we finally got our chili paste here together. So we're going to put in a couple spoons of that in here with the chili, and we're going to let this continue to simmer. Now, again, this is one of those things that you'll do to taste. And let's take a look at this. Let's get a little closer. Okay. This is our playoff chili. Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs. Yeah. And we're going to let this continue to simmer down. This is going to be so good. You see, See, there's bacon in there. There's the sausage in there. Two flavors of sausage. There's the beef in there, the ground beef and all that. And it's nice and saucy. And we're just going to let those flavors marry up in here. Now, again, use your chili spice to taste. If you like it hotter, put more cayenne pepper. I'm keeping this a little bit more on the medium side because my parents are going to get some and my in-laws, and I don't want to burn them out. So that's what we got. It's 2 hours and 10 minutes to kick off. We're going to let this simmer for another 2 hours.
You know what you could do? You could put hotness on the side.
There you go.